Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about Jira data center plan management. So whenever we are working into any projects and we have our data center versions available, then we can plan our project efficiently. So here, once you will log in, you will be able to see the screen. From here, just navigate it to the create plan. Here we can set plans, visualize or roadmaps by automatically or manually scheduling work for teams as we see fit. Otherwise, we can also set as a program group for plan. So we'll see here both the phases. So let's see, I want to create a plan for no restrictions. Here I'm giving just sample group plan. So is my plan name here, plan sample connected plans. I can set it up here and click on create. So now you can see the complete scope is available here. So as of now, we don't have anything, but we can add initiatives. So here, if we want to add the initiatives, definitely we have to navigate it to the Confluence pages. But if we want to plan it accordingly, we can set the complete configuration here. So if you want to learn about Jira data center, please watch my Jira data center playlist. Other than that, if you want to learn Jira cloud and API, please watch my Jira cloud and API playlist as well. So we were talking about the group plan. So when we are working with the group plan, we don't have any line items or status or any details are available here. Now to sync this, generally it will take some time. Otherwise, let me add some data. Because we have added the sample plan, you can see the sample plan detail. So here, let me add some more story 2, story 3. Now I want to add story 4. And story 5. This is done. So I want all this. Now you can see the status is in to-do. Let me navigate it to the sample plan. We have not seen anything here. Show. I can't see that story. Let me add some epic one. One as epic 2, epic 2. Now, if we want to create the plan, so simply I will click on create plan, provide the plan name. So here, sample plan 2, open access so that everyone can see. Now here I'm selecting the project, so I'm selecting the scrum projects. Set exclusions rule if we want, otherwise we can just proceed it further. So when we are creating a plan, you can see whichever epic is available here, we have those items. Other than that, we also have four user story. So if we want to add any epic or story, we can simply add it here. Even though if we just want to apply the filter, we can also add the subtask and story and epic filter. So even we have the filter from release, issue details, assigning, sprints, projects, issue resources, these all are auto filters are also available. Even we can filter it out according to 3 months, 1 year and fit, and even we can set the custom dates for the filter point of view. View setting, we can change it by group wise, none assignee, as well as component wise. If we want, we can set as label wise warnings. If we want to set this show warnings, then we can showcase the warning fields as well. In the team sections, we can add as many as teams we want. Otherwise, we can also invite the shared team members. Releases, if you want to create any releases, we'll simply click on create release one. So let me tag as 1.0 is my release name. Simply created this release name, and project is not tagged with this. So here, if we want, we can select any of the projects and then we are good. So this is our 1.0 and we have tagged within a Scrum project. Other than that, I'm also able to add dependency. So if we want to add any dependency, so that dependency is also available. We can add it simply by epic point of view or T point of view, these dependency, we can report it. So this releases, we have to approve it. And once it is approved, you can see this release is available. Now, even we can apply the dependency based on the subtask label. So this is how we can create a roadmap and plan for individual team members where we can share with any of our team members. Here we can set the warning center, which is configured, which type of warning we want to see in our plan. That is target data at beyond the due date, issue dates. So these all warnings are already there, but if we want, we can also filter it out based on the warning. Auto schedules are based on the all values, empty values and all. Share, if we want to share this plan with any of our team members, then probably we can share with them. Export, we can also export into spreadsheet. So this is how we are doing the planning. In terms of configuration point of view for the planning, we'll see in further part of video or in next video. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.